To get regular updates, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.
Hello friends, I'm Dipali Shah from Exambin. In this lesson, we are going to see about the directive principles of the state policy as per the Constitution of India and much more. Before getting started, do not forget to subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates. So, let's get started. Directive principle of the state policy. The directive principle of the state policy, which is also known as DPSPs, are guidelines to the framing of the laws by the government. These provisions set out in the Part 4 of the Constitution are not enforceable by the courts. But instead, the principles on which they are based are fundamental guidelines for the governance that the state is expected to apply in framing the policies and passing the laws. DPSPs and fundamental rights form the concerns of the Indian Constitution. The basic aim of the DPSPs is to set up the social and economic goals before the lawmakers, to bring about the socio-economic change in the country, to fulfill the basic needs of the common man, to reshape the structure of the Indian society in direction of the greater socio-economic equality. The Part 4 of the Constitution of India deals with the provision of the directive principles and are broadly classified into socialist principles, Gandhian principles, liberal intellectual principles. Socialistic principles: adequate means of the livelihood for all the citizens, fair distribution of wealth and material resources among all the classes and to prevent the concentration of wealth in the few hands. Equal pay for equal work as man as well as woman. To secure just and human conditions of work and maternity relief. Gandhian principles: to organize village panchayats and to endowing them with such powers and authority as may be necessary to enable them to function as units of self-government. To promote cottage industries on individual or cooperative basis in rural areas. To safeguard and promote the educational and economic interest of the scheduled caste and tribes. To bring about the prohibition and consumption of intoxicating liquor. To organize agriculture and animal husbandry on the modern and scientific lines, and in particular, prohibit the slaughter of cows. Liberal principles: to secure uniform and liberal code of law for all citizens of India. To separate the judiciary from the executive. To raise the standard of nutrition and standard of living of the people. To protect the monuments of historical and of national interest. Equal justice and free legal aid to economically backward classes. Participation of workers in management of organizations engaged in any industry. Promotion and improvement of environment and safeguarding of the forest and wild. Directive principle of the state policies explained as per the articles of the Indian Constitution. Social, political and economic justice. Article 37, while stating that the directive principles are not enforceable in any court of law, declares them to be fundamental to the governance of the country and imposes an obligation on the state to apply them in matters of the legislation. Article 38 directs the state to secure a social order with the economic, political and social justice for the promotion and welfare of the people. Article 38(2) says that the state shall strive to minimize the inequalities of the income, status, facilities, opportunities, etc. Principles of policy. Article 39 says that while framing the policies, state would strive to provide adequate means of livelihood, equal pay for equal work, resource distribution, and safety of the citizens and healthy development of the children. Free legal aid. Article 39A says that the state will try to make the legal system fair and would provide free legal aid by the means of some scheme or law. Organization of panchayats. Article 40 says that the state shall take steps to organize panchayats and endow them with such powers and authority as may be necessary to enable them to function as units of government. The 73rd and 74th amendments of the Constitution later culminated as constitutionally backed framework with this DPSP. Welfare government. Article 41 says that the state shall, within its limit of economic capacity and development, will make effective provisions for securing right to work, education, public assistance in case of unemployment old age, sickness, disablement, or any other case of undeserved want. Article 42 says that the state shall make the provision for securing the just and human condition for the work and for the maternity relief. Fair wages and decent standard of life. Article 43 says that the state will endeavor to secure by suitable legislation or economic organization or in any other way to all the workers, agricultural, industrial or otherwise, a living wage, conditions of work, ensuring a decent standard of life and full enjoyment of leisure and social cultural opportunities, and in a particular promote cottage industries on an individual or cooperative basis in rural areas. Workers' participation in management. Article 43A says that the state shall take steps by suitable legislation or in any other way to secure the participation of workers in the management of undertakings, establishments or any other organization engaged in any industry. Government has launched various schemes on workers' participation in PSUs to fulfill this directive. Promotion of cooperatives. Article 43B, inserted by the 97th Amendment Act in 2011, says that the state shall endeavor to promote voluntary formation, autonomous functioning, democratic control, and professional management of the cooperative societies. Uniform Civil Code. Article 44 says that the state shall endeavor to secure for the citizens a uniform civil code throughout the territory of India. Infant and Child Care. Article 45 says that the state shall endeavor to provide the early childhood care and educational for all the children until they complete the age of 6 years. Protection of Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe, Weaker Sections from Exploitation. Article 46 says that the state shall promote with special care the educational and economic interest of the weaker sections of the people, and in particular of the scheduled caste and the scheduled tribe, and shall protect them from social injustice and from all forms of exploitation. Nutrition, standard of living and public health. Article 47 says that the state shall regard the rising of the level of the nutrition and the standard of living of its people and the improvement of public health as among its primary duties, and in particular, the state shall endeavor to bring out the prohibition of the consumption except for the medicinal purposes of intoxicating drinks and of drugs which are injurious to health. Scientific agriculture and animal husbandry. Article 48 says that the state shall endeavor to organize agriculture and animal husbandry on modern and scientific lines and shall in particular take steps for preserving and improving the breeds and prohibiting the slaughter of cows and calves and other milch and draught cattle. Environment and wildlife protection. Article 48 says that the state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. Protection of monuments and places and objects of national importance. Article 49 says that the state will be obliged to protect every monument or place or object of artistic or historic interest declared by or under the law made by Parliament to be of national importance from spoliation, disfigurement, destruction, removal, disposal or export as the case may be. Separation of judiciary from executive. Article 50 says that the state shall take steps to separate the judiciary from the executive in the public services of the state. Promotion of international peace and security. Article 51 says that the state shall endeavor to promote international peace and security, maintain just and honorable relation between the nations, foster respect for the international law and treaty. Directive principles of the state policies added by the amendments of constitution. 42nd Amendment in 1976. The four directive principles were added by the 42nd Amendment as follows. To secure opportunities for healthy development of children in the Article 39. To promote equal justice and to provide free legal aid to the poor in Article 39A. To take steps to secure the participation of workers in the management of industries, Article 43A. To protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife by Article 48A. 44th Amendment in 1978. The 44th Amendment Act of 1978, added by the Article 38(2), which said that the state shall in particular strive to minimize the inequalities in income and endeavor to eliminate the inequality in status, facilities and opportunities, not only amongst individuals but also amongst groups of people residing in different areas or engaged in different vocations. 97th Amendment in 2011. Article 43B, inserted by the 97th Amendment Act in 2011, says that the state shall endeavor to promote the voluntary formation, autonomous functioning, democratic control and professional management of the cooperative societies. Further, the 86th Amendment changed the subject of Article 45 and brought it along with the fundamental rights as Article 21A for children of 16 to 14 age. The same article was now a directive principle to state to take care of the children below 6 years. Comparison of fundamental rights and directive principles. While most fundamental rights have some negative connotation, that is, they prohibit the state from doing something, the DPSP directs the state for doing something. While fundamental rights are enforceable in court, the directive principle of the state policies are not enforceable in the court. While objective of the fundamental right is to establish the political democracy, objective of the DPSP is to establish a social and economic order. While fundamental right have legal sanction, DPSP have moral sanction. The fundamental rights are individual in nature, while the DPSP are collective, that is, they promote the welfare of the entire community. Fundamental rights don't need the separate legislation as such because they are enforceable in court. To implement DPSP, government needs to make separate laws. With this, we have come to the end of this session. Thank you for watching till the end. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates. Thank you.